Cesar asked, how do I not repeat myself playing solos? Because he said, I know some leaks and some stuff, but then I feel I am repeating things all over. And I don't get like beyond these things that I know. So the question is a very good question, but here, one thing we need to do is expand our knowledge. If you feel you are repeating yourself, and on leaks or stuff, because this is the problem with leaks, which leaks are very limited, because the leak is not you, it's just a musical statement there of someone, and then you can make it yours, and it is interesting, it has some juice there also to learn leaks, but the thing is that it's not you, and those are limited. At some point you run out of leaks, and then you sound, or you sound like a leak, or you sound repeating those leaks and this thing. This is what I guess you are asking. And therefore, my answer will be that you need to expand your knowledge of rhythm, harmony, and melody. If you learn more rhythm, for example, like there is this excellent method of John McLaughlin, name is, this is the way I do. I will post in the description that, because this is the Konakol Indian system, which he used to create music and to improvise, of course. This is one way to expand it. Then another way is also learning Western rhythm and also learning melody and harmony as well, because you can expand this if you learn more about music, more about rhythm, more about harmony, and more about relationship between melodies and chords and all these things, and rhythm mainly, and use this, how to use also is important, not just theoretical, because in theory there is no difference between practice and theory. In theory, but in practice there is, because when we need to do something, there is a gap there, which has to be eliminated. And therefore, if you do that and expand your knowledge of rhythm, harmony, then you will see that actually there is no meaning of this repeating thing. You will find many more things to play, but you need to understand the language of music in depth and more profound way. If you learn that, And every day, in fact, in my lessons, in Skype, this is exactly what we do, to try to widen the horizons of the students so that they have many tools to choose to use when they create music. And then if you do that, then there is a limitless amount of things. You can do many, many, many things. So it's about getting more knowledge. This is the solution to not repeat. So at the moment, that's how I also, I guess you notice that because you also record yourself. But if you didn't do that way, I really advise that you record the things you play. When you record something, then you can see it from outside. Then that's what, how I notice this is repetition. And then you try to find other alternatives to place different material on those chords or on those segments or parts of the pieces. For those passages, there are several ways you can do many, many things, but actually sometimes we get so limited and then just drop the same phrase over and over. That has a solution, which is to enhance our knowledge and enlarge the possibilities. We will get more tools which we can use in those passages there, and then we just apply them. Of course, we need a teacher. Therefore, if you are interested, you can join the course on Skype, and I tell you exactly what to do for any level. And you will see how music is limitless. There is no limit, and there is no reason to be repeating stuff over and over. You will love it, how actually you get access to these limitless ways to express yourself.
La improvisación es algo que yo pienso que cada músico debería, cada músico del estilo que sea, del clásico, del flamenco, de cualquier otra música debería aprender, porque la improvisación te da mucha libertad y a la vez te da mucho conocimiento de dónde estás tocando, de cómo estás tocando, de qué armonías estás en cada momento, ¿no?
Muy bien. Pablo.
Sí, Paco, ¿qué es para usted la música popular y qué es la música elitista?
Yo creo que la música elitista es el refinamiento de la música popular. Por ejemplo, el flamenco. El flamenco originalmente es una música popular, la música del pueblo de Andalucía. Pero creo que ya no le pertenece más al pueblo, porque de pronto habemos gente que nos hemos pasado toda una vida encerrados puliendo esa expresión popular. Entonces ha llegado a un nivel en el que el pueblo ya no tiene acceso, sobre todo a los matices que vamos consiguiendo la gente como yo, que nos pasamos muchas horas elaborando esa música.